السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. هيا على الصلاة هيا على الصلاة هيا على الفلاح هيا على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة حتى تركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الكلام كلام الله تبارك وتعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Verily, all praise is due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His aid. We ask refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and the evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guide, none can lead astray. And whomsoever went astray, none can guide. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone with no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His slave and messenger. O you who believe in Allah, fear Allah in the way who should be feared, and I not accept in the state of Islam with full and complete submission to Allah. O you mankind, be dutiful to Lord who created you from a single person, that is Adam alayhi salam, and from him he created his wife, and from both of them he created many men and many women. Be dutiful to Lord from whom you demand your mutual rights. Keep tight relationship with your relatives, especially the kinship. Verily Allah is ever watcher upon you, O you who believe in Allah. Fear Allah and say the truth. He will rectify your deeds and He will forgive your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger will achieve a great achievement. The best of the speech is the speech of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the best of guidance is the guidance of our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of actions are the newly invented matters in Islam, where every newly invented matter in Islam is innovation in Islam, and every innovation in Islam is misguidance, and every misguidance will lead to the hellfire. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jal commanded us, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, in the Quran, and as well on the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to fulfill his rights, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And from fulfilling the rights of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is as well to show your gratitude and being thankful to Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala that He has guided you to the right path. and that He تبارك وتعالى enabled you to follow the right path, and that Allah Azza wa Jal enabled you as well to fulfill His rights. It is from the favors of Allah Azza wa Jal upon us that we are Muslims. And it is from the favors of Allah Azza wa Jal upon us that we pray the five daily prayer. And it is from the favors of Allah Azza wa Jal upon us that we are fulfilling His rights, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And see the reality. We are only percentage in this world, minority in this world. And from the Muslims minority, those ones who follow the right path, and from those as well minority who are fulfilling the rights of Allah Azza wa Jal. So all favors belong to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And He Tabaraka wa Ta'ala encompassed us with His mercy and His blessings, that we are fulfilling His rights Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. It has nothing to do with us. So that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, where Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in the Quran about fulfilling especially the 10 days of the Hijjah for those ones who attended the Hajj, and even those ones who were unable to attend the Hajj, where Allah told us in the Quran, وَلِتُكْمُلُ الْعِدَّةِ, so you fulfill the prescribed period of time, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ, and to glorify Allah Azza wa Jal, that Allah has guided you. So we should glorify Allah Azza wa Jal, glorify Him in the day and in the night, that He has guided us to this path, that He has guided us Tabaraka wa Ta'ala to Islam, to Tawheed, to Quran, to Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ, to glorify Allah Azza wa Jal for that He has guided you Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, so you may be grateful to Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, to be grateful to Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, we will need to understand as well, and even when Allah Azza wa Jal has revealed the ruling, the ahkam of tahara, the purification, the basics of Islam, after tawheed, the basics of Islam to purify ourselves, that to clean ourselves, and to purify ourselves physically and spiritually, to pray to Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Look at Allah Azza wa Jal, the verse after it, what Allah mentioned in the Quran. مَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيَجْعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ حَرَجٍ, Allah doesn't want hardship upon you, وَلَكِنْ يُرِيدُ لِيُطَهِّرَكُمْ, but Allah Azza wa Jal wants to purify you, وَلِيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكُمْ, and so He will fulfill His favors upon you, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, and as well, so you're going to be grateful to Him, and you're going to be thankful to Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, as Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentioned, rahimahullah, he said, تَأَمَّلْتُ أَفْضَلَ الدُّعَاءِ فَإِذَا هُوَ أَلَّهُمَّ أَعِنِّي عَلَى ذِكْرِكَ وَشُكْرِكَ وَحُسْنِ عِبَادَتِكَ. He said, when he was looking into all the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, and he found that the best dua that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, alayhi salatu wa sallam, he said, O Allah, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. O Allah, help me and aid me to remember you and to be thankful to you and to worship you in the best way. Look at this. You are asking Allah Azza wa Jal. You are asking the aid from Allah Azza wa Jal. You are asking the aid from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. You are submitting your will to the will of your Creator Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And to help you to do what? To help you to do what? To remember Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And to be thankful to Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And to worship Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala in the best way. This is the dua of your Prophet and our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This is his dua. And that's why his dua, alayhi salatu wasalam, used to say it just before his salah, or just after the salah, after finishing the salah. Just before finishing the salah. Or just after finishing the salah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With difference of opinion between scholars of Islam. Look at this. After you fulfill the rights of Allah Azza wa Jal, after he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is the best abid, the best worshipper of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. None has worshipped Allah Azza wa Jal better than him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And yet, he will make dua to Allah Azza wa Jal to help him, to remember him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. where his tongue always was remembering Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and yet he is asking Allah azza wa jal to remind him and to help him to keep remembering Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And he is the best person who is thankful to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And he was worshipping Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to the extent that even his heels used to crack sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the worship, from the night worship. And then Aisha radiyallahu anha used to say to him, O Messenger of Allah, Allah Azza wa Jal has expiated all your sins. Why do you worship Allah Azza wa Jal to that extent? And then he said, Aisha, أَفَلَا أَكُونَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا, I should be a thankful worshipper of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The best example, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best man who has walked on earth, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and yet he is asking Allah Azza wa Jal to help him, to remember him, and to be thankful to him, and to worship him in the best form, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah, you will find in the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal reminding his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if those ayat for him, what about us? Those ayat, Allah stated in the Quran, Allah says in the Quran, بَلِ اللَّهَ فَعْبُدْ وَكُمْ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ, worship Allah and be amongst those who are grateful to him, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, that we have revealed to you Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to the people before you, the messengers and the prophets of Allah alayhim as-salatu was-salam, if you associate with Allah partners, then all your deeds will be wiped. All your righteous deeds will be wiped. And you're going to be amongst the losers. And Allah says in the Quran, that's here, Allah says in the Quran, وَكُنْ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ, be among those who are grateful to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. All of these things, all of these ayat, for the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what about us? We are more in need to be thankful to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, this is to remind us, if the time of Hajj has finished and the year is finishing, I want you and everyone amongst us to sit down and analyze this year. And I'm talking about the Hijri year. From Muharram last, from the beginning of Muharram this year until the last day of Dhul Hijjah this year. What you gain in this year? What is the amount of knowledge that Allah has extended you with? What you gain of knowledge in this during this year? What you gain of the righteous deeds that you have done in this year? And as we look at yourselves, how many major sins that you have done, and how many things that you have done, and how many sins that you have committed, and how many crimes that you have done, wronging yourselves and wronging others. Look at this and analyze. And that's why when Allah enabled you and gave you tabaraka wa ta'ala the seasons of rewards and the seasons where Allah Azza wa Jalla will expiate the sins. Like for example, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said alayhi salatu wasalam, whoever fasted the day of Arafah, Allah will expiate the sins of the previous year and the sins of the coming year. And as well, if you commit something more, then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whoever fasted Ashura, that Ashura, to fast the 10th of Muharram, which is the beginning of the year, Allah will expiate the sins of the previous year from the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, these things we need to understand. That in Islam, to show gratitude to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, to be grateful to him tabaraka wa ta'ala for every single breath that comes in your mouth, every single breath that comes to you, you should be thankful to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And that means for every single second that Allah enabled you to live, that means there is a chance for you to remember Allah azza wa jal at least once. And there is a chance for you to seek forgiveness from him tabaraka wa ta'ala at least once. Because you never know, you may take a breath and it will never come out. Or the breath come out from you and you'll never get any breath again. You don't know. You never know. But here, my brothers and sisters, but we know that Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who forgives the sins. And we know that the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Messenger Alayhi Salatu Wasalam, he was sent with the truth. And he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, whoever his last statement, La ilaha illallah, will enter Jannah.
So that's why it's a chance, an opportunity for you and for me and for every one of us to take advantage for every single second that Allah enabled you to live. And in the same time, when Allah enabled you to live for another opportunity, Allah enabled you to live for another Ramadan during this year, and Allah enabled you to live for another 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, the best days in the year, and Allah enabled you to live in the best nights in the year, the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Allah enabled you to do that. And if you worshipped Allah Azza wa Jal, don't be so arrogant and proud that to think that you have done something major. You should even humble yourself to Allah Azza wa Jal as if you have done nothing. And you are not extending the kingdom of Allah Azza wa Jal in nothing, where you are only wanted the pleasure of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So that's why you should be thankful to Allah Azza wa Jal that Allah give you the opportunity that to live for another Ramadan, and to live for the last 10 nights of Ramadan, and to live for the first 10 days of the Hijjah, where Allah prevented others, and maybe some people better than me and you, and Allah prevented them to live for another Ramadan, and Allah prevented them to live for another 10 days of the Hijjah. People who are better than me and you, pious people, and yet Allah did not enable them to live for another Ramadan and to live for another 10 days of the Hijjah. That shows, my brothers and sisters, when Allah has favored you with something, which is especially the worship of Him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, you should be thankful to Him. We are thankful to Allah Azza wa Jal when Allah provides for us children, or when Allah provides for us wealth, or when Allah provides for us houses, etc. We should be more thankful to Him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, that Allah provided for you opportunity to worship Him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And that is the key thing, my brothers and sisters in Islam. And that's why our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the best example, alayhi salatu wa sallam. Allah, the best example, alayhi salatu wa sallam, when he was saying, alayhi salatu wa sallam, afala akunu abdan shakura? Should I be a grateful worshipper of Allah, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala? That was him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, giving the best example with him, alayhi salatu wa sallam, where Allah Azza wa Jal tested him that he took his children young, and all his children died before him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except Fatima. Look at this test, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Lived as an orphan, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Didn't even see, he didn't even live with his father and his mother. Didn't even see his father, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Lived poor, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And yet was showing his gratefulness to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and being thankful to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And he was worshipping Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in all ways. And he was remembering Allah Azza wa Jal in all his situations, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As narrated by Aisha, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to remember Allah Azza wa Jal in all his situations, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah told us in the Quran, in Surah Ibrahim, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. That Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in the Quran that if you are grateful to Him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, Allah will increase you. Increase you on what? Increase you on righteous deeds. Increase you on more opportunities to seek forgiveness from Him. Increase you on more opportunities to be thankful to Him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and to worship Him in the best form of worship, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوج المستغفرين أستغفر الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومواله. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jal has made His symbols, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, His sha'air. ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Those who consider the symbols of Allah Azza wa Jal great, this is signs of the piety of the hearts. Sign of the piety of the hearts. And the person would reach that status when the person is grateful to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. When the person fears Allah Azza wa Jal, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, alayhi salatu wa salam, ittaqillaha haythuma kunt, fear Allah wherever you are.
وأتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحها. And follow the evil deeds with the righteous deeds, it will wipe it. وخالق الناس بخلق حسن. And deal with the people with good manners. This is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why my brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned clearly in the Quran, it is the minority of the people who are grateful to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Where Allah stated in the Quran, إن الله لذو فضل على الناس ولكن أكثر الناس لا يشكرون. That Allah Azza wa Jal, He has favors upon the people, but majority of the people, they are ungrateful to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in the Quran, وقليل من عبادي الشكور. And little amount of my servants, little amount of the people, that they are grateful to Him tabaraka wa ta'ala. And Allah Azza wa Jal as well mentioned in the Quran, that when Iblis, when he was saying to Allah, challenging Allah Azza wa Jal, ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. And Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in the Quran, Iblis is saying to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, is saying to him that even he knows us, that is saying to Allah, I will come from in front of them and from behind them and on their right side and on their left side, and you will find the majority of them, they are ungrateful to you, to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So we should be grateful to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. As the hadith mentioned in by Imam Ahmad rahimahullah in his Musnad, he said, يقول الله يوم القيامة يا ابن آدم حملتك على الخيل والإبل وزوجتك النساء وجعلتك تربع وترأس فأين شكر ذلك. That Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in a hadith, even though some scholars, they said that hadith has issues in terms of narrations, but yet that Allah saying to the children of Adam, O sons of Adam, O children of Adam, we made you to ride the horses, and we made you to ride the camels, and we made you to marry your spouses, and as well we made you to be even a leader and to do whatever you wish. Where is your thankfulness to me? So subhanAllah, this is for the ni'mah of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the best ni'mah of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is Tawheed. Oneness Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And the best ni'mah that Allah Azza wa Jal has guided you to the right path. And the best ni'mah that Allah Azza wa Jal enabled you to worship Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So we should be grateful to Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And we should show our gratitude and thankfulness to Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala in the day and in the night. And it doesn't mean the days of the Hijjah, the Ramadan has finished, and the days of the Hijjah are finished, and then we start fresh. It's you should be thankful to Him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And as the Salaf, what they used to do, they used to ask Allah Azza wa Jalla for 6 months after Ramadan, that Allah to accept from them Ramadan. And that shows from their gratitude and thankfulness to Allah, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. The same thing for us. If they are doing such thing, what about us? Where we are busy in everything except remembering Him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So that's why this is what our duty is, my brothers and sisters in Islam. We should be thankful to Him. And we should, even for the people who are unable to achieve the best achievement in these 10 days of the Hijjah, yet we are in the month, on the sacred month, the month of Dhul Hijjah, and next month as well, another sacred month. So this is opportunity for you, as Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in the Quran about this month, فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ, meaning don't ruin yourselves in these days, in this month. The same thing, if the warning is severe in this month, similarly, that the reward is more and multiple in these days. So that's why I try your best, inshallah ta'ala, to achieve whatever you can. And as well, this day, the day of Jum'ah, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is an hour Allah Azza wa Jal will accept the dua. So make the dua and remember Allah Azza wa Jal and send salutation upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as Allah Azza wa Jal, especially on the day of Jum'ah. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned alayhi salatu wasalam, he said fa'akthuru min as-salati alayhi, increase sending salutation upon me sallallahu alaihi wasallam. عباد الله إن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ به بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه فقال جل من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم
وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأجل وأتم وأكبر. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. هيا على الصلاة، هيا على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استووا استقيموا.
الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله، إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى. ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى. سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى، الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا، قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى. بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا، والآخرة خير وأبقى. إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى، صحف إبراهيم وموسى.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. قل يا أيها الكافرون، لا أعبد ما تعبدون، ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد، ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم، ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد، لكم دينكم ولي دين.